Are bail-in transformers really necessary for your antenna connection? I'm not sure, but I'd like to find out, so let's hop to it. I was told quite a few years ago that in order to get the best TV reception signal, you needed to install one of these between the antenna and the coax cable. This is a balun or matching transformer. It matches impedance from the 300 ohm antenna to the 75 ohm RG59 coax. Without one, there is a chance of signal loss and interference. Well, that's what I learned, but is it correct? Does using a balun really make an actual difference to my TV's reception? I learned about baluns in the 1970s, so are they even relevant today? TV signals are now mostly UHF high definition digital versus the mostly VHF signals that were broadcast back then. Maybe things have changed to a point where you don't need a balun. I'm not sure, I'm just a hobbyist, not an electrical engineer, but I have been wondering about this. I have seen a lot of do-it-yourself antenna instructions that show how to attach the coax to the antenna directly without a balun. It apparently works, but does it work as well as if you had just used a balun? The only way I can be sure is if I test it. So here is what I did. Here are 2 6-foot lengths of RG59 coax that I tested with. They are both identical except I cut off the connector from one end, removed 1.5 inches of casing, and prepared the cable like the online instructions showed. The second cable has both F fittings. I hooked up my pie pan antenna indoors without a balun and ran a channel scan. I recorded the total TV stations I received and the overall signal quality. I have a local station, 62-1 Bounce TV, that is a challenge for most indoor antennas to pull in. I recorded if I did receive it at all and at what signal strength. I ran the test 3 times, 10 minutes apart, to get a good comparison. Next, I installed a balun and I ran the same series of tests. I then changed the antennas to my hoop multi-directional antenna and ran the same series of tests with that one. I've included links to construct both of these antennas in the comments section. The following day, I ran the same series of tests again, this time later in the day. The first day's testing started at 1 p.m., and the second day's testing didn't start until 7 p.m. I knew from experience that I can sometimes get different reception at different times of the day, so I was curious on how it would affect the results. So what do you think? Was there a difference? If there was it significant? I'd love to hear your thoughts and your comments on this. I took all of my raw data and I compiled it into 2 charts, one for each antenna. It's obvious that in my situation, the balun outperforms the non-balun cable connection. On the pie pan antenna, it results in almost a 1/3 increase in channels that I received, which is a significant amount. Signal strength and stability were drastically improved also. And without the balun, I was barely able to pull in channel 62-1. Results for the hoop antenna are similar. It also shows gains in all tests, also pulling in 1/3 more channels. I'm not going to say that these results will be the same for you and your antenna, as there are a lot of variables to consider. All I know is after doing these tests, I'm confident that a balun is important to my HDTV antenna. Thanks for watching. Please high-five the like icon, jingle the bell, and subscribe to my channel so you can see what else I'm going to be doing next. Until then, keep watching TV.